Welcome back to Breathtaking, the podcast celebrating all the things that take my breath away. Last week, in honor of National Thank a Mail Carrier Day, all of our episodes shared the theme, Wait a Minute, Mr. Postman, and we celebrated all things epistolary, mostly in the form of songs written in the form of letters. I saved one of those songs for this week. Have a listen and see if you can figure out why.
Give me a T!
T!
Give me an E!
E!
Give me an A!
A!
Give me an M!
M!
What do you got?
T!
There is no team like the best team, which is our team right here. We will show you we're the best team in the very little league this year. And in no time, we'll be big time with the big league baseball stars. For all we have to do is win just one more game, and the championship is ours.
Dear Pen Pal, you'll never guess what happened today at the baseball game. It's hard to believe what happened today at the baseball game. I was the manager, Schroeder was catcher, and all of the team was the same as always, but somehow or other, disaster struck at the baseball game.
There is no team like the best team, which is our team right here. We will show you we're the best team in the very little league this year. And in no time, we'll be big time with the big league baseball stars. For all we have to do is win just one more game, and the championship is ours.
Three balls, two strikes. The bases were loaded with two men out. So I pitched my curve, but somehow he hit it a good strong clout. Lucy, I hollered, it's coming right to ya. She caught it as easy as pie, then dropped it. I don't think it's good for a team's morale to see their manager cry. Snoopy helped out by biting a runner and catching the ball in his teeth. And Linus caught flies from a third-story window by holding his blanket beneath. Yes, we had fortitude, no one could argue with that. And one run would win us the game as I came up to bat.
No team right, like the best team, which is our team right here. We will show you we're the best team.
Men were on with two outs and me with one strike to go. Then I saw her, this cute little red-headed girl I know. Firmly I vowed I would win it for her, and I shouldered my bat and I swung. Dear pen pal, I'm told where you live is really quite far. Would you please send directions on how I can get where you are? Your friend, Charlie Brown.
That was T-E-A-M, the baseball game, from You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, based on Charles Schulz's wonderful Peanuts comic strips with music and lyrics by Clark Gessner, sung by Gary Berghoff, who, parenthetically, went on to great fame playing the role of Radar in the television series MASH. And I saved the song for this week because this week's theme, Having a Ball, celebrates spring training, which begins on February 28th. The thread weaving today's musical offerings together is not only baseball, but childhood as well. So up next is the heartwarming Right Field, written by Willie Welch and performed by Peter, Paul, and Mary.
One, two, three, one. Saturday summers when I was a kid, we'd run to the schoolyard and here's what we did. We'd pick out the captains and we'd choose up the teams. It was always a measure of my self-esteem, 'cause the fastest, the strongest played shortstop and first. The last ones they picked were the worst. I never needed to ask, it was sealed. I just took up my place in right field, playing right field. It's easy, you know. You can be awkward, you can be slow. That's why I'm here in right field, just watching the dandelions grow. Have lefties that pull. I dream of the day they hit one my way. They never did, but still I would pray that I make a fantastic catch on the run and not lose the ball in the sun. And then I'd awake from this long reverie and pray that the ball never came out to me. Here in right field, it's right easy, you know. You can be awkward, you can be slow. That's why I'm here in right field, just watching the dandelions grow. Strikes on the batter, some runners are on. I don't know the inning, I've forgotten the score. The whole team is yelling, and I don't know what for. Suddenly everyone's looking at me. My mind has been wandering, what could it be? They point to the sky, and I look up. You gotta know how to catch, you gotta know how to throw. That's why I'm here in right field, watching the dandelion grow.
Our podcast concludes with The Ninth Man by A.B. Rottenberg from his fabulous album, Journeys One. Because the album features songs relating to Judaism, I had assumed, the first time I glanced at its track list, that this song had to do with finding a minyan, that is, a quorum of 10 men for prayer services. It was only upon hearing this delightful song that I realized that the subject matter was largely about baseball.
Thank you. We were young yeshiva boys way back in 65. We were known throughout the city as the bums from the east side. In school we never studied, all we did was laugh and play. No Rebbe ever lasted long, they all just ran away. Rebbe tried to teach us Torah each and every day, but we just closed our eyes and ears to everything he'd say. And all we liked to do was sit and watch our TV sets. We'd talk about the Yankees and the Dodgers and the Mets. Well, the principal brought the new Rebbe in the first day of the term, and he said to him, show discipline, be strong and tough and firm. Don't think these youngsters run the school, he said with a big frown. And by the way, for the next few weeks, I'm going out of town. But this here Rebbe, he was strange, he never lost his cool. He just kept on teaching while we broke all the rules. And though we hadn't even learned a single word all year, it was Pesach time already, and the Rebbe was still here. Rebbe tried to teach us Torah each and every day, but we just closed our eyes and ears to everything he'd say. And all we liked to do was sit and watch our TV sets. We'd talk about the Yankees and the Dodgers and the Mets. But Omer came around, it was time to play that game. Against those boys from Brooklyn, how we prayed it wouldn't rain. All nine of us got on the bus with our gloves and bats. Rebbe also came along in his jacket, tie, and hat. Right from the start, we all could see things weren't going right. Some big strong kid from Bensonhurst had hit one out of sight. And just when things were looking up, tide about to turn, our catcher went and broke his leg while sliding into third. It's a forfeit, cried the other team, you only got 8 guys. No, we don't, a deep voice said, much to our surprise. Since I am their Rebbe, well, the fair thing it would seem is let me be the 9th man, the 9th man on this team. Rebbe went, picked up a bat, faced a pitcher with a smile. Knocked the cover off that ball, went about half a mile. He flew around the bases to score the winning run. We danced and cheered until he said, now boys, you owe me one. The next day in the classroom, no one moved and no one stirred. Rebbe started teaching, and his voice, it could be heard. We all said, hey, it's interesting. The man, he is no bore. The legendary East Side bums were gone forevermore. Rebbe used to teach us Torah each and every day. We opened up our eyes and ears to everything he'd say. No more did we sit all day and watch our TV sets. We talked about the Rashi and the Tosfos.
Please join me for Having a Ball Part 2 when we'll be moving from childhood to adulthood and its intersection with sports. Till then, I'm signing off for now with a song in my heart.